For the third year in a row, Lake Orion celebrated the 4th with a boat parade on the lake. More than 30 participants gathered at the boat club the morning of the 4th to begin the parade. This year's theme was the Olympic Games to coincide with the event taking place in Atlanta this year. Residents, politicians, business leaders, and officials circled the lake in about an hour and a half, waving to onlookers along the way. A team of judges were on the lake as well, given the task of selecting the best in five categories: best decorated in the Olympic theme, best decorated overall, best entry by youth, best antique, and best entry by business. Participants came back to the boat club for refreshments and to find out which entries came away with awards. Receiving the award for best antique was Tom Neblett. A new category this year was the youth category. That award went to Greg Rogers and Charlie Zed Kowalski. The Commodore's award for best vessel entered by a business went to Donaldson Animal Hospital. Their big blue gorilla could be seen for miles.
Well, we had a lot of balloons last year that got blown away because of the high winds, and so we went for bigger balloons this year.
So you got the biggest one you could find.
We found the biggest balloon we could get. We only hit one wire, just skimmed a wire, but we're okay. And then we've got to have him back to Hudson's before Thanksgiving, so he's going to hang out for a while.
The award for best overall went to the members of the Orion Historical Society.
We were very surprised. We didn't even try. What could we do if we try? We could probably take all the awards.
What kind of work went into it?
Yeah. Pardon?
What kind of work went into it?
Well, Ken Doty made the Olympic logos out of hula hoops, and so that was really what took it. We think we got it because we had the biggest hoops.
And finally, the award for best Olympic-themed entry went to representatives of Sarowski and Associates for their hopelessly lost bobsled team.
We took a left turn in Warsaw and ended up here in Lake Orion. The people of Lake Orion have been very accommodating. We want to say thank you.
And he's our navigator. It was kind of a joint effort, really. I tell you, we just were talking about the Olympics. That's the theme this year. Oops, almost lost the trophy. And I don't know, we all start talking about, let's have it funny, you know, let's do something funny. And of course, our company, Sarowski, that's Polish. And then the Polish bobsled came out. We said, we got to make that funny. And it was great, you know, like we're lost. We're on our way to Atlanta for the Summer Olympics, and we're a winter team.
This is the third year of the Venetian Parade since its revival in 1994. After a decade-long hiatus, it looks like the event is once again becoming an expected annual Lake Orion tradition.
It's definitely here to stay. I could have never been more proud or overwhelmed by the success of a new program in our community. We all know the story of about how the traditional street parade kind of faded off and lost interest, and we tried to do this and bring back the spirit of the lake and celebrating the 4th of July, and the success has just been overwhelming, and it's owed all to the participants because they come out and give up part of what to many people is an important day, and we're really happy and proud for them.
The boat parade may draw residents to the lake to enjoy the spectacle, but another Lake Orion tradition seems to be drawing crowds from throughout the metropolitan Detroit area. As they do each year, volunteers provided another spectacular fireworks display over the lake. For months, the volunteers, led by Glenn Stokes, raised the funds necessary to put on the show. A big part of the money raised comes from a benefit held each year at Nick Christie's Orion House. Donations and fundraisers combined raised about $13,500, up from last year's total of $12,000.
Well, I'm going to say 13 grand is going to buy us a half hour to a 40 minute show, and it's going to be fast and furious. Anybody that knows the way we do these shows sees that there's no lull in the action. I mean, they're up and they're fast. We're fast. We get them up quick.
Hours before showtime, the volunteers arrive in Greens Park on M24 to prepare. Trenches are dug near the shore and the guns are put in place and packed in tightly. The shells are unloaded and sorted into size. Shannon Scheidler took us on a mini tour.
And these are salutes, which are color and very loud. Look at them. These are the wicks, obviously. It tells you right on them. I don't have to tell you. Colorful salute. So they'll probably start right on the very end one. These are real nice. These are the big boys. and they're going to start at the very end here, work their way right down.
And this was what kicks everything off, right?
Yeah, this is where we, this will be the starters.
The first ones you got closest to us are 6-inch guns. Now, I'm in charge of the 5 and 6s. Those are mine. Obviously, they're called the CR because of the size of the shell. 6-inch being a 6-inch shell will go into it. You saw the guns before we put them in. They're probably about this tall. We try to pack them a little over halfway at least, because when it goes off, there's good vibration. It packs them down. So if you don't pack them far enough, they're coming up with the shell, which you don't want. Like I said, I know we have 86 inches tonight, shells we're shooting, 135 5-inches, and even 104 inch ones. I think there's 385 3-inch guns, plus all the stuff on the dock. There's 12 8-inchers, 12 7-inchers, 8 10s, one big 12. They usually go closer towards the end.
Just talk about why you do it, why you get into this.
Excitement. We don't get paid, so I mean, it's, you have to like doing it. This is my 10th year doing it, so it's addicting, I think. You know, it's just, you look forward to it. I mean, I bring 12 guys here with me that are friends of mine. And it's one of those things, you either really like it or you never come back and do it again. And I've brought friends before that have done it one night and it scared them so bad they have no interest in doing this again. And it used to be our family could sit down here by where the bathrooms are now.
Yeah.
And we had a bad night. The wind was blowing back. We caught the gazebo on fire 3 times that night. And now my wife and them won't come down here. They sit down in front of the bank where they can see the fireworks, but they can't see us. I caught on fire that night. Some stuff come down on my back. I jumped on a box to protect it. My coat caught on fire. One of the guys had to put me out. So she won't come anymore. But yeah, it's part of the fun.
Once the setup work is done, volunteers have a little fun until nightfall.
I'm going to tell you something. There's a lot of people that come out here that are just so unselfish. I mean, they do it because they enjoy
each
lighting fireworks, yes, but they put in their time digging these ditches, working, doing whatever they have to do, and nobody's too big to do anything. I mean, if you ask somebody to pick up a shovel and help you over here, everybody helps each other out. Like I said, we've got our guy Glenn, too, that works so darn hard, collects money all the time, runs around for the whole 2 weeks prior to this, going to Indiana, going down to southern Michigan, going to Pennsylvania, going wherever he has to go to pick up the fireworks. And hey, without him, this show is not possible, no doubt about it.
When night falls, the event begins. Some of the volunteers are assigned the tasks of loading the guns, while others light the wicks, creating a display that thousands will remember, at least until next year.
Another reason people are saying that this year's events were the best yet was the Lions Club's Jubilee. Impressive considering that after last year's event, there was discussion that the Jubilee would be history. As in the past, Pew Shows provided the rides, games, and refreshments that brought families into the downtown area of Lake Orion during the 4th of July weekend. But it wasn't this aspect of the Jubilee that raised concerns of village officials last year. The beer tent brings in a large percentage of the revenues raised during the four-day event, and it was here that the Lions Club made changes to satisfy Lake Orion officials and the police department, like wristbands identifying those over 21 years of age.
What we did different is we not allowing the teenagers coming in after 9 o'clock. That's the big difference.
What happened last year that inspired these changes?
We had too many teenagers taking beers off the table, so we kind of put the nap to that one.
What did you specifically do to try and keep the underage in control this year?
Oh, you got to be over 21 to get in the beer tent. You got to be with your parents, though. If you're with your parents, you're okay. If you're not with your parents, you ain't coming in. Simple as that.
The Jubilee is the Lions Club's largest fundraiser of the year. Last year's event brought in more than $40,000. The money raised helps provide Christmas baskets for local needy families, which is just one of the Lions Club's many charitable activities.
Basically, it's a great fundraiser so we can carry on our projects for the community and for the blind. And we're expanding that a lot to help the kids in the schools, hearing impaired. We are the good fellows in our area. We average probably 120, 125 families a year. and with the Christmas baskets ranging probably up to $400 to $500 per family.